What's going on, Fragrance Family? This is Tyler with Simply Fragrances, and today I'm bringing you my top 10 designer list for the upcoming spring. So if you want to see what these fragrances are, be sure to keep it right here. Welcome back. Like I said, my name is Tyler. This is my channel, Simply Fragrances, where we talk everything fragrance related. We're doing top 10 videos. We're doing seasonal videos, weekly fragrance rotations, smelling rates, interviews, everything that encompasses fragrances you can find right here. So if that sounds like something that you want to be a part of, be sure to hit that red subscribe button. I would really appreciate that. If you're a returning subscriber, man, thank you so much for the love and support you have shown this channel. I really do appreciate that. So like I said, guys, this is going to be my top 10 designer list for the spring of 2022. So I wanted to kind of switch it up a little bit. Now there's going to be some heavy hitters in there, you know, stuff that's probably on everyone else's list, but I wanted to kind of, you know, shift gears a little bit and veer towards fragrances that no one really talks about anymore, or maybe not even at all, that I think definitely deserve a spot on a spring list. So got some really good ones for you. Got some ones that you're like, oh man, I even forgot that was around. So really excited to get into this list. So let's go ahead and dive in, guys. So coming in at the first spot, these are no particular order. This is one of my just all-time favorite fragrances. I love this stuff. The dates in here give this just a beautiful sweetness to it. And nothing else really smells like this, to be completely honest, guys. What am I talking about? I'm talking about John Varvatos, Varvatos, however you want to say it. This is the original. And man, it's just a good gentleman smell. Like, not gentlemanly, like, you know, old school fougere. Like, it's just a good manly fragrance, guys. This is, it's kind of got this woody spiciness going on, almost like an oriental vibe to it. But the dates in here do give it a bit of a sweetness. And it's just a smooth, solid fragrance, guys. This stuff is absolutely gorgeous. If you haven't got your nose on it, man, I recommend it. You can get it all day for like 25, 30 bucks on fragrance.net, Fragrance X, places like that. Go ahead and give this one a try, guys. John Varvatos, the original. All right, guys, so making our way down the list. This is one of those fragrances that, like I said, maybe no one talks about. I know for a fact no one has talked about this one except for me, at least in my realm of people. I don't know if there's even a review on this one, to be completely honest, but I love this stuff. It is amazing, guys. The mint that is in this fragrance, it's just, it captivates me, guys. And the creaminess, guys, what am I talking about? This is coming from the house of Mandarina, and this is Mandarina Duck. This is black and white. And my goodness, guys, this is a solid spring fragrance. So what you're gonna get off this is a lot of citrus. You're gonna get the orange blossom like you get in the original Mandarina Duck Black. You're gonna get that sweet vanilla, but there's a creamy mint in here. And the best way I can describe it, the mint that's in here, it reminds me of something like you'd find in like mint chocolate chip ice cream. So you get that creamy just smoothness, you know, from the ice cream, but then you get the mint that's tucked into the ice cream. Guys, this is an absolute just springtime must have, in my opinion. I love this stuff. Like I said, you do get the other citruses in there. From the orange, you get the vanilla in here, and it still has that kind of oriental spicy, you know, woody vibe to it. But this stuff, slept on, get it all day for like, I don't know, 25, 26 bucks. Guys, you guys need to get this in your collection. Mandarina Duck, black and white, had to be on the list. All right, guys, so moving right along with the list, this should come as no surprise. This will probably make a lot of people's top 10 list in the designer realm for the upcoming spring, and for good reason, guys. This stuff is, in my opinion, it's a staple in anybody's collection. They should definitely have this. And I don't know, I just love this stuff, guys. This is Mont Blanc Legend Spirit, and it's just a dang good fragrance. Like, let's keep it real, guys. This stuff is super good. It's supposed to be like their interpretation or rendition of the original 2016 Invictus Aqua. I can't really attest to how close this is to it. You know, back then I wasn't like super into collecting. I had like a small collection, but I wasn't going to like Dillard's or Sephora, places like that, and, you know, smelling everything just to smell it, you know? So if I did smell it, then it didn't, you know, leave leave a long-lasting impression enough for me to remember it. But everyone says that with the Mont Blanc, they get better projection, longer longevity, and just overall a better fragrance in their opinion. So I don't know, can't attest to it. But what I can say is this stuff, super fresh, super clean. It does kind of have this spicy woody note, you know, kind of tinge to it. And so it makes it really good for like those in between spring days where, you know, it's not exactly cold outside. There might be like a kind of a cooler breeze, if you will, but it's still kind of warming up outside. It's just kind of like one of those perfect spring fragrances, in my opinion. So that's why it had to be on the list. All right, guys, so moving right along with the list. This is also from one of my favorite houses. I don't talk about it too much, but I do have a big love for this fragrance, and I think that this one definitely needs to get more love. Don't really see anybody talking about it. What am I talking about, guys? This is Hugo Boss, and this is Boss Bottled Tonic. And man, this is just a really good, solid springtime fragrance. It kind of takes that original DNA. You get like the apple in there, and that almost kind of like that warm apple pie vibe that you get in the OG, but they've added some more citruses in here. There's this blue woody kind of style to it, and it just brightens it up and makes it honestly really, really good. I don't know why people don't talk about this. The longevity, it's not gonna be super great. You're probably gonna get 5 to 6 hours off of it, but honestly, it's a great, safe, easy fragrance. And in the springtime, guys, this one, it's gonna get you noticed, it's gonna get you some compliments, and it fits that springtime profile just perfect. So Boss Bottled Tonic definitely had to be on the list. All right, guys, so I had to pull out the big guns. I couldn't have a springtime fragrance list without Versace Eros. Yes, it had to be in here, guys. This is, I mean, it's a staple in the fragrance community at this point. This stuff is absolutely amazing. It is a monster, especially the older batches, which is what I think I got. I know this came out around 2011, 2012, somewhere in there, and this was just a clubbing monster. Like, this is what everyone was wearing because of the projection, but it's also fresh, it's clean, it's kind of powdery, it's got this lemon and mint in the opening with some apple. Man, this stuff is absolutely gorgeous, guys. This is perfect for those springtime days where you know, it's not quite chilly, but it's got that warm kind of vibe to it, but maybe there's a like a chilly breeze or something like that. Guys, this stuff, the scent trail that you would leave behind you, man, it's intoxicating, and this stuff goes on for miles and miles. People will be able to smell you from 2 blocks away, so be careful and easy on the trigger with this, but this is gold, guys. All right, guys, so moving right along with the list. This next one on the list, man, it's kind of got this like old school, like late 90s, early 2000s vibe to it. Just this real fresh, clean, kind of musky with some woody tones to it. It's honestly just a really great springtime fragrance, guys. And this is Perry Ellis EDT. Now, this is actually, it's kind of hard to find this one in a sense because there's so many different Perry Ellis fragrances and they're all EDTs, so it kind of makes it hard to pinpoint. But from what I did a research on, this one, if you type in Perry Ellis EDT 100 ml, this one should pop up. Now, there's one that looks like this, but it has this little leather, little like strap on there, if you will, and they're similar, but they're not quite the same. This one, it's got grapefruit, it's got woody accords, it's got leather, iris root, and just some musk is what I was looking up. But man, this stuff, it's honestly super good, clean, fresh, with those woody accords and that grapefruit, it kind of gives it just like a tartness to it, and it's absolutely amazing, guys. Great for those spring, kind of cooler spring days, and honestly, it had to be on the list, guys. Okay, guys, so moving right along with the list. This one comes from one of my favorite houses. This is one of my wife's all-time favorite fragrances, guys. This will always be in my collection. It's a great all-year-round fragrance, but I think this stuff shines in the springtime. Guys, this is Yves Saint Laurent, and this is just L'Homme, the original. Man, this stuff is so good, guys. It's got this ginger note in here that is absolute to die for. It's kind of fresh, spicy, powdery, a little woodsy, some citruses in there. And man, it is just a dang good fragrance, guys. This is like a staple in the fragrance community, a staple in a lot of people's collections, and I think it should be in yours as well. Great for the springtime, so versatile. Anytime, anywhere, any occasion, dress it up, wear it casual. It's gonna get you where you need to be, guys. Yves Saint Laurent L'Homme had to be on the list. All right, guys, so next on the list, this is actually my scent of the night. Like, I love this stuff. I don't know why this has slept on. I don't really see people talking about it a lot. I know I've talked about it. Ross from TLTG, he's talked about it. He's actually the reason why I picked it up, because he hyped it up so much. Guys, this stuff, it needs to be talked about more. It needs to be loved. What am I talking about, guys? This is from Giorgio Armani. This is Acqua di Gio, di Gior, however you want to say it, but absolute. And this is absolutely amazing, guys. This is a fresh, kind of spicy, a little bit woody, aquatic, citrus, amazing fragrance, guys. This is perfect for the springtime and the summertime, actually. Really great for the high heat, but the woody facets makes it super great for the springtime weather, especially like spring nights and stuff like that. This stuff is honestly kind of a powerhouse off my skin, which is saying a lot coming from a fresh fragrance. Sometimes you don't get the best longevity or projection, but I mean, this stuff, guys, it dances off my skin for some reason, and my wife loves it. I got several compliments from it, you know, including her. So that's the biggest facet right there that we look for as a married man, especially when your wife tells you that you smell good. Man, that is a winner chicken dinner. So Acqua di Gio, absolutely had to be on the list. All right, guys, so next on the list, this is gonna be an attention grabber. I kid you not, guys. Sounds crazy, because that actually comes from, you know, a cologne house, a copy house, a inspiration house, whatever you wanna call it, a dupe house. You know, there's lots of names for them, guys, but this stuff absolutely is gorgeous. This is Armaf's, and this is Club de Nuit Sillage. This is their rendition of Creed's Silver Mountain Water, and this is spot on. Like, this is absolutely amazing. This, in my opinion, is better than the current formulations of Creed Silver Mountain Water. It lasts longer, it projects harder. I mean, it pulls in the compliments, and it's a direct copy, at least in my opinion, of Creed's Silver Mountain Water. Now, this one, you gotta be careful, guys. I did 4 sprays the other day, and I worked at church, and people were like, man, you smell good, but you are way too strong. You put way too much on. Cause that's only 4 sprays, and this stuff lasts every bit of 10 to 12 hours, at least off of my skin. My wife really enjoys it. It's very unisex, at least in my opinion. If you've never smelled Creed Silver Mountain Water, you're like, man, what are you talking about? It's kind of a hard fragrance to describe, not gonna lie, but it's kind of got this creamy, like tea vibe to it, with some citruses and woody facets. It really is a kind of its own scent profile. So if you haven't smelled that, guys, this is only $40. Man, I cannot recommend this enough. This is absolutely gorgeous, great for the springtime, and you're going to be getting attention, guys. This, the scent trail that you leave behind, guys, they named it appropriately, sillage, the scent trail, the scent bubble, whatever you want to call it, that you're going to leave behind you. Absolutely killer, absolutely stunning, absolutely a stunner in my opinion, guys. Club de Nuit Sillage had to be on the list. All right, guys, so we are down to the last fragrance on the list. Thank you so much for watching this far. I really do appreciate that. Now, a lot of my OG subscribers and my regular viewers, they're probably thinking, man, this is a spring fragrance video, and we haven't seen a barbershop fragrance. Tyler, are you okay? Yes, I'm perfectly fine. I'm not sick or anything like that. I just had to save the best for last. You know what I mean? Not really. I mean, I love this fragrance, but guys, you know me. I can't have really almost any kind of video, but especially a springtime video, without having a great barbershop fragrance in there, guys. So what fragrance am I talking about? This is coming from the house of Tom Ford, and this is Beau de Jour, however you want to say it. But guys, the creamy lavender that is in here, and the oak moss that you're gonna get, man, this is like next level stuff, guys. This is absolutely amazing. This is, you know, it does have a more mature vibe to it, but I think honestly, guys, if you have the confidence to wear anything, you can pull it off, guys. So I mean, I wouldn't recommend it for, you know, someone under 20, but if you guys dress the part and you have the confidence to pull this off, I think you can rock it. It doesn't just, you don't have to be someone in, you know, their 40s and above wearing this stuff, guys. I'm not even 30 yet. I'll be 30 in April, so you know, still rocking stuff like this with confidence, man. The right fit, this will get you noticed, this will get you the compliments, and on a beautiful spring day, guys, this is just gonna play magic. Now, this does, in my opinion, you know, scream for, you know, a more dressed up, you know, look. You know, you can maybe wear it, you know, casually if you wanted to. That's not how I choose to wear it. If I'm wearing this stuff, it makes me wanna put a nice watch on, maybe a nice button-up shirt, maybe a jacket or something like that to go with it, and it just completes the fit. But that one, guys, it had to be on the list. Tom Ford's Beau de Jour, man, Alright guys, so that's going to do it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. I really do appreciate that, guys. Be sure and comment down below what you thought of my video, what you thought of the list. Do you agree with it? Do you disagree with it? What are some of the fragrances that you would put in the list? Guys, honestly, I wanted to include some fragrances that don't really get a lot of love, that, you know, either get slept on or maybe some people don't even know about them. So I wanted to be a little bit different, and obviously got to include some of the heavy hitters, but I wanted to give some other fragrances a spotlight to shine, because I definitely think they're worthy to be in a top 10 video. So be sure and comment down below what you thought of the video. That's going to do it for the fragrance portion. I'm going to catch you guys here in a second at the prayer part. But like I said, that's going to do it. Comment down below. I'll catch you there. I'm also going to catch you on the next video. And remember, if you love it, wear it. So like I said, this is going to be a time dedicated to prayer. Honestly, this has gotten a lot of positive feedback. Honestly, a little bit better than what I was anticipating. So thank you guys so much for that. But I didn't do it on the last video just because we were at like 27 minutes. And so I didn't want it to go super long. But normally I will be doing, you know, the last couple minutes for a time dedicated to prayer. So guys, let's go ahead and do this. I did have a prayer request from a subscriber. He said, you know, he just overall wants more people to join the kingdom. So definitely going to be praying for that, and then obviously praying for the Ukraine situation. So if you guys would, I invite you guys to pray alongside of me, and I'll get going. So Father God, we just thank you so much for the day. Thank you so much for just your blessings, and we just thank you so much for just the little things in life that we often take for granted and just don't give you enough praise on. So God, thank you for those. And right now, God, I just want to pray for just overall more people to just hear the gospel, God. And that honestly falls back on us as Christians to go and share the good news, to go and share about the kingdom and share what our experiences are, God. We often think we have to, you know, always have the right words, or we have to be, you know, a preacher or a missionary to do this, God. But God, you said that we just need to go, God. It is the great commission to go and to baptize people amongst all nations in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, God, and teaching them to observe and obey everything that you taught the disciples, God. We are called to go and make more disciples. So I just pray for just a boldness and a faith to rise up in people who, you know, they might have this stirring in their gut to go out and share the gospel with their friend or with their neighbors, or, you know, even just while they're out and about, you know, grocery shopping or, you know, doing whatever, God. I just pray that you would give them the confidence and boldness to do that, God, and that your words would just flow out of their mouth, God. And obviously, God, right now we just want to pray for the Ukraine and Russia situation, God. That, man, war is just always a crazy thing. And God, anytime there's casualties or anything like that, God, that just, man, it breaks my heart, and I believe that it breaks yours. And God, so we just pray for the civilians over there, God, that just the craziness that they're experiencing right now, God, that they're having to flee their homes, and man, just, I can't even imagine the fear that that they're having. So God, I just pray for peace over them, peace over that nation. And God, I just pray that the Christians in that nation, God, the Christians in that country, God, that they would use this time to just be a light in the darkness, God. That this would be a chance for them to love on people and to show them the gospel and to show them who you are, to, God, let them know that that there is hope for tomorrow. And God, we just thank you so much for everything that you've given us. And God, we just ask that you bless this day and bless tomorrow as well. And God, thank you so much for giving me this platform. God, we love you. We bless you. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, guys, so that's going to do it for the time of prayer. Thank you again so much for watching. And guys, comment down below if you have any prayer requests. I would love to pray for those. Guys, I'm going to catch you guys on the next video. Peace.